Let's now talk about function operations. The sum of f and g, which is notated as f plus g, is defined by f plus g of x, and it actually means just you take your function f of x and you add it to g of x. The difference of f and g, which is notated as f minus g, is defined by f minus g of x, which again just means f of x minus g of x. The product of f and g, which is notated as f times g, is defined by f times g of x, and it just means f of x times g of x. And then lastly, the quotient of f and g is f over g, and it's defined as f over g of x equals f of x over g of x. And notice that in this case, g of x cannot equal 0, because if it did, then we would be dividing by 0, which is undefined. In all cases, the domain of these operations is the intersection, and sometimes you're going to see an intersection notated with this little upside down U kind of looking like thing. That's the intersection symbol in math, and it means you should find the elements that are common to two sets. So when you're asked to find the domain when you're doing operations of functions, it's the all of the input values that go into both f and g. So when you're writing this out, make sure that whatever the x values are that you state, they can go into both of these functions. We'll get into an example of that in a minute. For the functions f of x equals negative 2x plus 3 and g of x equals 5x minus 3, find and fully simplify the following. State the domain of f plus g of x and f times g of x. All right, so let's go ahead and do this. When I do these types of problems, the first thing that I always do is I write out what this notation means. So f plus g of x is f of x plus g of x. This does not mean f plus g times x. Again, this means f of x plus g of x. So we'll write out our f of x function, which is negative 2x plus 3. And then we'll add our g of x function, which is 5x minus 3. And then once we've done that, we'll combine our like terms. Negative 2x plus 5x is 3x, and 3 minus 3 is nothing. So we're left with just 3x. Now to find the domain of this, so again, the domain when you're doing operations of functions are all values that will go into both f and g. So when I look at f, I can input any value for x, and I'm going to get an output for output value. Same thing for g. I don't have any square roots, and I don't have any rational functions. So this is going to be the domain that goes into both f and g is all real numbers. Okay, let's look at f minus g of 1. So again, this doesn't mean to take f minus g and then multiply it by 1. This means f of 1 minus g of 1. So we're just subtracting those two output values. Let's figure out what f of 1 is. So f of 1, you'll plug in 1 for x. I get negative 2 times 1 plus 3. And then I'm going to subtract g of 1, which is 5. Times 1 minus 3. Make sure that you're writing these in parentheses, because I'm not just subtracting the 5 times 1, I'm subtracting the entire quantity g of 1. Okay, simplifying these out. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2 plus 3 is 1 minus 5 times 1 is 5. Minus 3 is 2, and 1 minus 2 is negative 1. Looking at this next one, f times g of x. So that means f of x times times g of x. F of x is negative 2x plus 3 times g of x, which is 5x minus 3. I am more than fine with you leaving it just like this. But if you want to take it further, you're more than welcome to. So we can FOIL this out, and I get negative 2x times 5x, which is negative 10x squared. Negative 2x times negative 3 is positive 6x. 3 times 5x is 15x. And 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. Combining our like terms, I get negative 10x squared plus 21x. Minus 9. And for this one, again, the domain is going to be all real numbers. I don't have a rational function, and I don't have a root of even index. So there's nothing I need to exclude. This last one is finding f over g of negative 1, which again just means f of negative 1 divided by g of negative 1. So that gives me, plugging negative 1 into f, I get negative 2 times negative 1 plus 3 all over 5 times negative 1 minus 3, which becomes 2 plus 3 over negative 5 minus 3. Gives me 5 over negative 8. And that is it. Last example. For the functions f of x equals the square root of x plus 1 and g of x equals the square root of 5 minus x, find f plus g of x and state the domain. Okay, adding these together, f plus g of x equals f of x plus g of x. Put in what f of x is, which is the square root of x plus 1. And also put in what g of x is, which is the square root of 5 minus x. And now there's nothing more I can do at this point for simplifying. That's it. Now finding the domain. We stated that the domain, when you do operations of function, are the values that go into both f and g. So let's find the domain of both of these, and then we'll see what those overlapping values are. So the domain of f. So those, since we're looking at a square root function, it's going to be all of the values that are going to make that square root bigger than or equal to 0. So I get x has to be bigger than or equal to negative 1. For the domain of g, that's going to be, again, I'm looking at a square root function. So it's going to be all of the values that are going to make what's underneath that square root sign bigger than or equal to 0. So I get that x has to be bigger than or equal to negative 5. Divide both sides by negative 1, which means we have to flip the inequality sign. And we get that x has to be less than or equal to 5. Now, some students can look at this and see right away what the overlapping things are, but I personally think it's easier to just look at a number line. So if I did a number line on this, okay. So I'm going to show what f is. So f are all of the values that are bigger than or equal to negative 1. So it's going to be all of those values. And for g, it's going to be all of the values that are less than or equal to 5. So we can see that these overlap right here. So the values that will go into both f and g are going to be those values from negative 1 up to 5, including both of those. So again, the domain is the intersection. It's the values that will go into both functions. So that ends up giving us this region right here. If you're finding you're needing some extra resources on prerequisites, I really recommend that you watch these following videos. Here's a video link to interval notation, and the big one that I'm assuming a lot of students need review on is factoring. Please feel free to let me know if you still need more resources other than that. Remember, I'm only a click away, and I'm always here to help.